إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صلِّ على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. My dear respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. We continue. This is lecture number six, actually, number six, in explaining Surah Tabarak alladhi biyadihi al-mulk, chapter 67. From the Quran, a chapter which subhanallah has a very special status. It will intercede for you in the day of judgment. It will stand out for you in the grave to protect you from the fitna, and consequently to be saved from the punishment in the grave. But again, ya ikhwa, for those who understand the meanings and they strive to act upon it, the Quran was revealed to be understood. Kitabun anzalnahu ilayka مبارك ليدبروا آياته. A book which we reveal to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it's a blessed book in order for us to reflect upon its meanings, and the reflection should lead to action. Today inshallah, very short and simple message. Verses 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. From verse number 14 to verse number 18. And all these verses except number 14, of course, because we're supposed to explain it last lecture, but we didn't have a good amount of time. But the 15 all the way until the 18 verse, they are within the same يعني pattern. Let's read them. The first verse: ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. ألا يعلم من خلق. استفهام تقريري. Shouldn't he who has created know? وهو اللطيف الخبير. And he is the most subtle. اسم الله اللطيف. Probably the English word doesn't ring the bell. Subtle is kind of. But really, اللطيف. And we'll explain it inshallah in more details. اسم الله اللطيف. You know, I like that line which a lot of times we use. God works in a mysterious ways. That's a latif. That he does things in a very precise, concise. He delivers them in a very perfect manner, to the finest little detail. Al-Khabir, there is a need for that name, اسم الله الخبير, the all aware. For you to do that, for you to do that delivery, you must be what? خبير. You must be all aware. You must be acquainted. You must know what you're doing. Otherwise, you're not going to be delivering. ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. Then comes in this verse. هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور. He it is who has made the earth subservient to you. ذلولا, شوف الأرض يا إخوة, earth, you walk in it, you run on it, you sleep on it, vegetation comes out, you dig it sometimes and you bring out gold, silver, minerals, all type. ذلولا, ذللناها. You see, subhanAllah, sometimes earth goes out of control and then you start appreciating how earth is subservient to us. Like when you have an earthquake, you know, one of the bounties that we don't pay attention to, that earth is qarara. Allahu alladhi ja'ala lakum al-arda qarara. Allah, it is Allah who made earth stable. Now you appreciate that when you have earth shaken for just 1 minute. What happens? Everything collapses and so forth. فهو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها. Walk in the shoulders of earth. يعني العلماء, the scholars, they say المناكب يا إخوة is the shoulder in reference to the high mountains. So if you're able to walk in these mountains, that means you can walk in where? Every place else. وَكُلُوا مِنْ رِزْقِ, and eat from his provision, سبحانه. But remember, you're here for a temporary duration of time. وَإِلَيْهِ النُّشُورِ, and you will die and you will be buried in earth and you will rise from it. مِنْهَا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ, from it we created you. وَفِيهَا نُعِيدُكُمْ وَمِنْهَا نُخْرِجُكُمْ تَارَةً أُخْرَى, and into it we shall send you back, in reference to death and burial, and out of it you shall come out again for resurrection. هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور. Then comes in two questions. أأمنتم من في السماء أن يخسف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور, which is really what I spoke about. Now earth is a place of security, and now are you secure, are you feeling secure from the one who is above the heaven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he would make earth swallow you? So instead of you walking on the surface of earth, earth will do what? Swallow you. And guess what? There is somebody who actually been swallowed by earth. Actually multiple. But the most famous one was who? Qarun. فَخَسَفْنَا بِهِ وَبِدَارِهِ الْأَرْضِ. We made earth swallow him. Imagine earth swallowing the person. أَأَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يَخْسِفَ بِكُمُ الْأَرْضَ فَإِذَا هِيَ تَمُورُ. تَمُورُ يعني shakes, earth shaken, like in an earthquake. Look, طب what if this does not happen? أَمْ أَمِنْتُمْ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاءِ أَنْ يُرْسِلَ عَلَيْكُمْ حَاصِبًا. What about the pebbles, the rocks, the stones? A strong wind can circulate that stuff around, and who was punished by this? Huh? عاد. عاد إذ أرسلنا عليهم الريح العقيم ما تذر من شيء أتت عليه إلا جعلته كالرميم. Imagine that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would turn these pebbles into what? Into bullets basically. أم أمنتم من في السماء أن يرسل عليكم حاصبا فستعلمون كيف نذير. And if you're in a state of denial, listen, nations before you. Of course, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing Quraysh at this stage, but He addresses every nation. If you're in a state of denial that you're thinking that this may not happen to you, you know what? وَلَقَدْ كَذَّبَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَكَيْفَ كَانَ نَكِيرٌ. Nations before you belied. They did not believe. They belied the messengers. They said no to submitting, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them. So these are the verses, ya ikhwah, which we will, inshallah, try to understand. First of all, the context. The previous verse, Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, rahimahullah, compiled Hadith ibn Abbas, رضي الله عنهما, that the people of Quraysh, the disbelievers, between themselves, they had a conversation. They said what? Once we speak bad about Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, or about Allah, let's do this in secret. So رب محمد, the Lord of Muhammad, doesn't know. Allah revealed the verse, وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوِجْهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ بِذَاتِ الصُّدُورِ. Subhana. Whether you disclose what you say or whether you hide it, Allah knows it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ikhwah, knows what you're thinking about before you think about it. And subhanallah, He doesn't hold us accountable for that either. يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى. He knows what you conceal of a secret and what is hidden inside your chest. But out of His mercy, He doesn't hold us accountable for what we think about. And the last couple of verses in Surah Al-Baqarah were revealed regarding this matter. Hadith Abi Huraira, radiyallahu anhu, wal hadith akhrajahu al-Imam Muslim, that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed this verse, لله ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وإن تبدوا ما في أنفسكم أو تخفوه يحاسبكم به الله فيغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير. To Allah belongs what's in the heavens and what's in the earth, and whether you reveal what you're thinking about or conceal it, keep it in secret, you're going to be held accountable for it. You're going to be punished for it. Imagine this. So I'm thinking right here, and I'm entertaining the idea of stealing. Done. Of done. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Abu Huraira narrates, they came to Rasulullah, وَجَثُوا عَلَى الرُّكَبِ. They went down in their knees. قَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. They said, O Messenger of Allah, جَاءَنَا مَا لَا نُطِيقُ. We can't handle this one. أُمِرْنَا بِالصَّلَاةِ فَقُلْنَا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا. We were commanded to pray, we said we hear and we obey. أُمِرْنَا بِالزَّكَاةِ. We were commanded to pay zakah, فقلنا سمعنا وأطعنا. We said we hear and we obey. أمرنا بالجهاد فقلنا سمعنا. This one, no, we can't. يا إخوة, الصحابة, the companions of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, they always the type that strives to attain excellence in executing the command. And they knew that the human cannot do that. It's very difficult. Very difficult. They will not be able to, but they will not rejecting the command. But here is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam immediately reminded them, and he said to them, أتريدون أن تقولوا كما قال أهل الكتابين من قبلكم سمعنا وعصينا. Do you want to say like the followers of the two books before you, in reference to who now? Bani Israel, the Jews, the Torah, and the Christians, and Musa. They said what? سمعنا, we hear and we disobey. وعصينا. That's not it. That's not how you deal with the command of Allah. قولوا سمعنا وأطعنا. Say we hear and we obey. شوف سبحان الله أبو هريرة, look what he said. Look, 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 look. فزلت بها ألسنتهم. As soon as they heard this, سمعنا وأطعنا يا رسول الله. See, their intention was not to object or reject. Like I said, that's why Abu Huraira, they said, their tongue slipped with it right away. They didn't think about it. They didn't think about it. And هذا بالتوفيق. This is توفيق الله. Other person will say what? But يا رسول الله. And we have an example. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَأْمُرُكُمْ أَن تَذْبَحُوا بَقَرَةً. The whole chapter of Al-Baqarah is about what? Is about this concept. You know how many stories were mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah? Many stories. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose that particular story to name that beautiful chapter which you recite in your house. Shaitan runs away from your house. Why? Because it's about this concept. Musa is asking his qawm, his people, to slaughter a cow. Huh? They said, what? Come on, are you making fun of us? Are you making a mockery? قال أعوذ بالله أن أكون من شوف ادعو لنا ربك يبين لنا ما هي ادعو لنا ربك يبين لنا ما لونها ادعو لا دي وذ ادعو لنا ربك يبين لنا ما هي إن البقرة تش they don't want but الصحابة right away say سمعنا وأطعنا سمعنا وأطعنا فزلت بها ألسنتهم. Now immediately Jibreel عليه السلام comes down with what? لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها لها ما كسبت وعليها ما اكتسبت. But after they said what? آمن الرسول بما أنزل إليه من ربه والمؤمنون كل آمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله لا نفرق بين أحد من رسله. ها وقالوا, they said what? سمعنا وأطعنا. Allah said, okay, no more. You're only accountable for what you actually execute, not what you think about. وعندنا حديث ابن عباس يا إخوة المشهور في صحيح الإمام مسلم and others that من هم بحسنة. If you intend to do a حسنة, just for your intention, look at this now, just for your intention, a حسنة is written. طب, what if you execute it? Like if you're sitting right here, inshallah, I'm intending to give a صدقة. You intended this, حسنة is written. Just for the intention. But you understand here that you're not, okay, I'm going to intend, then I'm okay, you can do this with Allah. That's what we're, that's, you see, if this is your dhan of Allah, then there is something. Those are the people we're talking about. وَأَسِرُّوا قَوْلَكُمْ أَوْ جَهَرُوا بِهِ إِنَّهُ عَلِيمٌ. He knows the innermost self inside you. Because some people, okay, well, man, okay, I'm going to give a sadaqah. And inside him, he already, but I'm not going to give it, yeah. Just to get the hasana. That doesn't go this way. You actually intending, resolving that you will give a hasana. You will give a sadaqah. A hasana is written. What if you actually do it? What will happen? 10 times multiplied. ولذلك يا إخوة سبحان الله, you can make a lot of حسنات if you just work on the chest, just the chest. You can, that chest can be a source of حسنات for you. طب look at the other one, look at the mercy of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. سبحان الله. ومن هم بسيئة. And if someone intends to do something wrong, nothing is written. Nothing is written. طب if you do it one سيئة one to ten ولذلك الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم سيد ويل لمن غلبت عشراته أحاده. Woe to the one that the tenth will outweigh the one. That means there's something wrong here. طيب, look at the other hand. What if he does not do it because of the fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? A hasana is written. Like he intend to do something wrong. And later on, you realize that this is haram. A hasana is written. الشاهد يا إخوة is whether we disclose or reveal what's in the chest, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows about it. Why? Because Allah created us. The creation. For you to understand the relationship between al-ilm wal-khalq, you must visit the subject of al-qadr. The belief in al-qadr. يا إخوة, القدر له مراتب أربع. For you to have belief in القدر, you must believe in these four levels. سموها مراتب أو مراحل. You must believe that Allah سبحانه وتعالى knew everything. Allah knew it. In the past, Allah knows everything in the present. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows everything in the future. What about the hypothetical? The hypothetical too. If you say, what if, Allah knows it. علم الله ذاتي أزلي. The knowledge of Allah is أزلي. This is number one. Number two, he wrote it. He wrote that knowledge. In what place? اللوح المحفوظ. When? 50,000 years before Subhana, he created the heavens and the earth. وده في حديث عبد الله بن عمرو بن العاص في صحيح الإمام مسلم. إن الله كتب مقادير الخلائق بخمسين ألف سنة قبل أن يخلق السماوات والأرض وكان عرشه على الماء. سبحانه. Imagine, he wrote everything which will happen until the day of judgment 50,000 years before he created the heavens and the earth. عبادة بن الصامت الصحابي يا إخوة المعروف المشهور, one of the companions who given the pledge of Aqaba, he was dying, passing away. والأثر في سنن أبي داود ومسند الإمام أحمد. فهسن الوليد was out of town. So he was in Medina. Somehow the news got to him that your father is dying. فالوليد immediately traveled back to Medina. Run. He enters into the house. He sees his father laying down, going through the agonies of death almost. السلام عليك يا أبتي. السلام عليكم, my father. أوصني. Leave me with a will, please. شوف سبحان الله, he's coming rushing all the way. All the way. I want to catch his father. Please leave me with a final farewell words or wasiyah that can benefit me. Again, Ubadah ibn Samit is one of the narrators of the hadith and he is knowledgeable. And oh father, make it a goodwill, please. Imagine this. He was laying down. He asked the people sitting around him, help me sit. So he sat and he looked at his son and he said, Ya Bunayya, my son, إِنَّكَ لَن تُدْرِكَ حَقِيقَةَ الْعِلْمِ بِاللَّهِ. You will never be able to attain the true knowledge of Allah. That's one wording. The second wording, you will never be able to taste the sweetness of faith. لَن تَطْعَمْ طَعْمَ الْإِيمَانِ. The taste of faith. حَتَّى until تُؤْمِن. Until you believe with certainty, without any doubt, أنما أصابك لم يكن ليخطئك وأنما أخطأك لم يكن ليصيبك. That whatever inflicted you was not to miss you. And whatever missed you was not to inflict you. Look. هذا هو الصحابي. A Sahabi, a companion, will never speak like this without referencing. Why I'm telling you this, my son? فإني سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول, because I heard the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, إن أول ما خلق الله القلم, the first thing which Allah created was the pen. ثم قال له اكتب. Then Allah commanded the pen to write. The pen said to Allah, أكتب ماذا يا ربي؟ أكتب ما هو كائن إلى يوم القيامة. Write every little thing which will happen until the day of judgment. So that's level number one. So Allah knew it. And then Allah committed that knowledge into writing. ألم تعلم أن الله يعلم ما في السماوات وما في ما في السماء وما في الأرض إن ذلك في كتاب. Don't you know that Allah knows what's in the heavens and what's in the earth? All that knowledge is in the preserved tablet, في اللوح المحفوظ. طيب, comes number three, الإرادة. That whatever he knew, it will happen. And wrote, he must will for it to come, to exist. He must will. Allah must al-irada. He must will it. And that takes power. You know, it's exactly, brothers, and we taught the subject of al-qadr here in a series, a whole series. It's like you want to do a project. What is the first thing that you do? You gather knowledge, right? And then what do you do? What's the next step? It's called feasibility study, right? Feasibility study, right? So you write that knowledge into what? So now can you bring that project into existence? That takes what? Takes what? That's sometimes we go with partnership. Don't we go in partnership sometimes? Oh, Sam, can you partner with me on this, please? Because I can't. Does Allah need that? Allah goes with partners because... لا. Allah must... ما شئت كان وإن لم أشأ وما شئت إن لم تشأ لم يكن. Whatever you will, O Allah, will happen. Even if I don't want it. But whatever I will, it will not happen unless you will it. وهذا معنى إيه؟ وما تشاءون إلا أي يشاء الله. Allah His will. Then comes in the, وهذا هو موضوع الشاهد. I'm sharing this with you, إخوة, for this. Comes in the fourth level. What is the fourth level? What is the fourth level? Bringing it into existence. اللي هي الخلق. اللي هي الخلق. The creation of that. That he knew. That he wrote. That he willed. Then he makes it happen. Right here. But look. Right here. According to what? Knowledge. Not random. And he knows it. That's why أَلَا يَعْلَمُ مَنْ خَلَقْ. Doesn't the one who created it? Because before the creation was what? Was knowledge, was writing, was the will to do it. اللي هي المشيئة أو الإرادة. فالخلق is the final stage of التقدير. وده شوف إيه. Look, تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا. الذي له ملك السماوات والأرض ولم يتخذ ولدا ولم يكن له شريك في الملك وخلق كل شيء فقدره تقديرا. That he created it according to his تقدير, in accordance to his knowledge, whatever existed before. ولذلك يا إخوة, we read that story in the books. That one of the people was teaching a class, and he's an atheist. He's trying to spread his ilhad, يعني his atheism. He teaches physics or science or something. So one day he brought a jar of, and he put inside that jar, you know, dead meat. Meat of a dead animal mixed with some mud and clay. And he said to his students, you guys say that God creates and all of that. I can create like God. I can create like God. Okay. He said, I'll be back in 3 days and I'll show you. Look at that jar. Just look at it. So 3 days later, you know, of course, that will develop into worms. So he came and he opened the jar. And he said, look, I created these worms right here. From clay. So one of the students was smart. He said, sir, how many worms are there? How many of them are females and how many of them are males? You create what? You must know what you created, right? What did you create? You must have the knowledge of that. That's a key. ولذلك ألا يعلم من بالله عليك, if this glass is broke, you're gonna go to the maker. Even they tell you what when you have a car and your car is not working okay, they tell you take it to the who? To the who? To the mean, a dealer. Why the dealer? Because the guy made it. He made it. Likewise, Allah made me and you. So He knows who you are and who knows. That's why, يا إخوة, ألا له الخلق والأمر. The Sharia, the Deen, the commands, the laws should belong to who? To Allah, because He knows what will make us function. This is the line which says, الخلق يستلزم العلم. The creation necessitates that you know what you created. But a good question here, what is the difference between the knowledge of the created my knowledge and your knowledge and Allah's knowledge. صفة العلم لله صفة ذاتية. The attribute of knowledge pertaining to Allah is an attribute of the essence. What do you mean by the attribute of the... You know, we divide attributes into attributes of the essence and attributes of the actions. صفة ذاتية, صفة فعلية. صفة ذاتية is part of the essence, part of Allah. It existed from the day Allah existed, subhanah. Which he existed without what? هو الأول. Without what? Without what? A beginning. So he's always knowledgeable. But you and me, before that knowledge that I had about these verses today, I didn't have knowledge. I was what? Say it. I was ignorant. Then I gained the knowledge. But Allah always what? Knew. That is why sometimes you read in the Quran, وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا وَكَانَ. And Allah was knowing. Because he always what? Knew. But the knowledge that I have today, what could happen to it? What? Wallahi al-Azim, sometimes brothers meet me in some cities and they tell me, Sheikh, I remember that lecture that you given and it was about this. Wallahi ma fakar aslan qulti. Yeah, yeah. Oh yeah, that was a lecture. I said that, yes. Yeah, did I make a mistake? Or no, no, no. What about fazuk? But Allah doesn't what? Doesn't forget. He doesn't forget. Subhanah. And this is what Fir'aun, لما سأل موسى, Fir'aun asked موسى, فما بال القرون الأولى? What about the nations that were destroyed before us? شوف موسى. قال علمها عند ربي في كتاب لا يضل ربي ولا ينسى. شوف شوف شوف. يوم يبعثهم الله جميعا فينبئهم بما عملوا أحصاه الله ونسوه. When Allah will resurrect us and he will tell you of things that you did, Allah knows it but you forgot it. فعلم الله doesn't. ولذلك يا إخوة في صناعة الحديث, in the science of the hadith, there is one of the علل أن الراوي اختلط. That the narrator, when he narrated the hadith, he was very good memory wise, sound wise, intellect wise. But when he got old, he started what? اختلط. Because his memory is not what? As solid as he used to do. This one, by the way, they question his hadith. يقول لك اختلط في آخر عمره. Towards the end of his life, he started what? I don't recall the name of the narrator. He has a daughter. Subhanallah, and I will tell you something. His daughter did the best thing for him. And his daughter, when she found out that her father is starting to forget things, she put him in the house. You're not going out. You're not going to go out of the house. You're done. Why? Because if he goes out there and starts messing up, the people who assess these narrators, oh, اختلط, he write اختلط, خلاص. All that hadith that he narrated is threatened. He said, you sit here, you die, because you can keep, I don't know if you know what I'm talking about or not, but this is this is way, you know, with Allah, no, it doesn't go this way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't forget this. Look, your knowledge, because how you attain that knowledge? How do we attain that knowledge? How do we attain our knowledge? Through what? The senses, the faculties that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to us. But oh, listen, وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْءٍ. Allah brought you out of the wombs of your mother. Don't know what? Don't know what? A thing. وَجَعَلَ لَكُمْ. And he given you what? A sama. That's the first thing, the first sense or the first faculty that gets activated. الْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ. So this is how you, طيب. How much can you see? طب, let me ask you this. How much, compare what you don't see with what you see, which is bigger? Come on, answer me. فَلَا أُقْسِمُ بِمَا تُبْصِرُونَ وَمَا لَا تُبْصِرُونَ. You can see here and now. Do you see the parking lot? Do you see India? Do you see Japan? Do you see Cairo? Allah sees everybody at the same time. Allah hears everyone at the same time. For His knowledge is what? Don't even compare your knowledge to His knowledge. Give me a break. So الحديث, لو أن أولكم, حديث أبي ذر في صحيح الإمام مسلم, لو أن أولكم وآخركم وإنسكم وجنكم, the first of you Adam, the last soul born, jinn and ins would gather in one place. اجتمعوا في صعيد واحد. Imagine all of us, jinn and ins, would stand and each one of us will make a request. ثم سألني كل واحد منكم مسألته. Of course, you're going to ask for a car. I'm going to ask for a house. He's going to ask for a wife. He's going to ask for children. Each one will have different what? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hear us all at the same time and He will deliver at the same time. فسبحانه ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned two attributes which are necessary to that knowledge. And اسم الله اللطيف يا إخوة, for you to understand it, the most common used word in English is the subtle or the most subtle, S-U-B-T-L-E. But of course a lot of the brothers, especially يعني, immigrants in particular, they don't, what's the subtle, what is that? I mean, اللطيف derives from two words, two nouns. من لطف أي دقا ومن لطف اللي هو إيه الحنان, kind, gentleness. So both. Very delicate and very gentle. Very delicate and very gentle. Delicacy here, and I said the word, the sentence, he works in a very mysterious way. And if you really want to grasp this name, Yusuf alayhi salam, at the end of his story, he used it. What did he say? إِنَّ رَبِّي لَطِيفٌ لِمَا يَشَاءُ. My Lord is latif regarding what He wants. See, look at this story. And by the way, you have a story like this, but you just have to reflect upon your lives. Imagine this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted someone to come from Canaan, Palestine, to come to Egypt in order to teach Tawheed. The people in Egypt were worshipping idols. To teach them Tawheed, Allah chose Yusuf. And for him to do this task, he has to be empowered. He has to become powerful in this country, even though he's a stranger. How did Allah deliver this? Ya Allah. Look at this. You need to understand that these things happen in a very human way. And the pattern of them is a human pattern. Look at this. Yusuf is a beautiful. He has half brothers who are very jealous of him because their father is more inclined to Yusuf. He's more attached to Yusuf, yeah. Showing more love and compassion for Yusuf. So, subhanAllah, look at the beginning of the story. The beginning of the story. Yusuf sees a dream. 11 stars, the sun and the moon. Please don't tell this to your brothers. Don't. Yusuf, by the way, never told that to their brothers, to his brothers. But his brothers still what? Throw him in a well. And look at this. A caravan traveling. You need to understand this is how it happened. It's not. Me and you, we look at the final product. We're reading the final product. But imagine Yaqub lost his vision over because of crying over Yusuf. The caravan takes him to Egypt. They sold him in the slave market, the market of slaves. Who picks him up? Al-Aziz, the second man in command. Latif, Rabbu, Latif or not Latif, delicacy, delivery here. Delivery here. And then he ends up in that house. This woman falls in love with him. And then he ends up in jail. And then in jail, here he is, worshipping Allah, really behaving himself, giving da'wah. And look at this. Another piece that has nothing to do with Yusuf. There was a conspiracy in the palace that some people are trying to poison the king. They accused two individuals. The butler, the one who used to make the drinks, the barman, bartender, yani, and the baker, the one who used to cook. So they said, both of you go to jail until we investigate this matter. They go to sleep, each one of them see a dream. The baker basically saw that he's going to be hanged, because that's how Yusuf interpreted it. And the butler, the bartender, so that he will be restored to his work again. He's going to go back to the palace and make drinks. The king is sleeping, sees the tree, seven healthy cows, seven. And then he calls upon his, has nothing to do with Yusuf. I said, guys, I'm seeing that dream. What is it? Oh, adghathu ahlam, nightmares. Guess who's walking around giving drinks to these guys? And he's hearing that the king is really suffering. Every night he goes to sleep, he sees that dream. I can help you. I remember this guy I used to be with in jail years ago. He interpreted my dream and he was right. Let me go and do it. Latif. اسم الله اللطيف. That's why Yusuf said, إن ربي لطيف لما يشاء سبحانه وهو اللطيف الخبير. It is he, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, اللطيف الخبير. Are we running out of time? Man, I haven't even warmed up yet. سبحان ربي. So you want to call the adhana, Abdul Karim, or shall we finish? Yeah. طيب. We stop here, inshallah, بإذن الله تعالى. Good enough? وهو اللطيف الخبير. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is Al-Latif and also the all acquainted, the all aware. And like I said, the Ikhwa, there is a significance always between two names of Allah put together. You see, for Allah to be Latif Subhanah, He has to be what? Khabir, to be able to do that. Maybe in 2 minutes or so. Look at the story of Musa. Exactly the same thing, the story of Musa. Out of this world. If you want to talk about Al-Latif. Bani Israel were in Egypt, enslaved. Bani Israel were the Muslims. They were enslaved. Like us now. Like the Muslims now. Exactly like. That's why Allah kept talking to us about Bani Israel all the time. Because Allah knew that we're going to go through their what? The weakness of faith, weakness of tawheed. Only if you... But subhanAllah, Allah preserved our guidance. Let's connect this to the story of Yusuf. When did Bani Israel come into Egypt? When? First of all, who's Israel? Yaqub, Jacob, the father of Yusuf. Now, if you read the story of Yusuf towards the end of the story of Yusuf, Yusuf said what? اذهبوا بقميصي هذا فألقوه على وجه أبي يأتي بصيرا وأتوني بأهلكم أجمعين. Take my shirt, cast it into the face of my father, by the will of Allah, his vision will be restored, and bring all your family to Egypt. So, Bani Israel, the children of Yaqub, existed in Egypt during Yusuf. Now pay attention here. During the time of Yusuf, Egypt was occupied by a force came from the east. That is why you read, وَقَالَ الْمَلِكِ The king said, not the pharaoh. The title of the ruler is what? Malik. So they are not the pharaohs, not the Egyptians. So when Egypt was liberated, Bani Israel stayed behind. But they always looked at them, they existed during the time of occupation. That means they were helping them. You know, like you existed in occupation, you guys were helping them. So he immediately started enslaving them. Put them into bondage. And again, we go back to the dream. You know, subhanAllah, even the kafir, sometimes he may see a dream that is... Father Pharaoh kept seeing this dream. All of this, ikhwa, was mentioned in Athar Ibn Abbas, ismu Hadith al-Futun fi Sunan al-Imam al-Nasa'i. That a fire came all the way from Jerusalem, entered the houses of the Egyptians, and did not enter one single house of Israeli, Bani Israeli. What is this? So they immediately, the people said to him, listen, they are talking about a newborn who will deliver them from bondage. What should I do? Kill all of them. Kill all the newborn. So he started executing. Imagine if a woman is pregnant. He would have his guards by the door. As soon as they hear whack, 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 grab the baby from the mother, separate the head from the... But then they kept doing this for years. Then they started losing the... We don't have no more slaves, no more slaves. If you're killing these boys, we don't have people to serve us because these guys were our slaves. So what should we do? Kill them 1 year and spare them another year. Alternate, yani. Take your chances. Ya ikhwa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Latif, Al-Khabir, He willed for Musa to be born the year that he is supposed to slay the children. That shows you what? Al-Aliyyul A'la Al-Muta'al. Aliyyul Qahr. Wallahu Ghalib. Always. Allah has superiority. That's why we don't read anything about the birth of Harun, right? Harun, by the way, was born in the years he is to spare the children. We don't read that Musa's mother threw Harun into the river. No, because he was born during that time. Who picks him up? You will pick him up. And you will raise him for me. Again, ya ikhwa, you need to understand that this happened in a humane way. You know that the mother of Musa, when she saw وَأَصْبَحَ فُؤَادُ أُمُّ مُوسَى فَارِغًا فَرَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ يَعْلَمْ وَهُوَ اللَّطِيفُ الْخَبِيرُ. Inshallah, we continue. بإذن الله تعالى, we said we're going to do 5 verses. We only did 1 verse. Alhamdulillah. جزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والحمد لله رب العالمين.